We just made this giant 6 foot long kitchen farmhouse sign using some scrap wood that we had and our Glowforge. And we learned a couple of things with our Glowforge, and we're gonna share those tips with you right now. What is up? Welcome back. Do you like to do it, build it, or make it? Great, and that's what we do on this channel every week. Megan knows. This week, we're making a super long kitchen farmhouse sign to go over our back door where our kitchen meets the backyard. It's like the wilderness.
Yeah, this is huge blank space above that window. No.
To the window?
To the wall.
To the wall.
Yes, it's a huge space above our door. It's a double glass door, and it's just a big empty space above there, and I really think it needs a nice farmhouse sign. So that's what we're gonna make today, and I'm making it 6 feet long.
6 feet long. Damn, but we're down to nubbins. We have like very little scraps.
Well, this week's project was going to be a farmhouse desk.
Yeah.
Because I need a new desk now that I'm working from home in my day job. That was our plan, but our, what is it? Our wood order?
I was gonna say our wood order has been delayed for the fourth time.
Yeah. Guess what I learned? They do curbside pickup. Guess what I'll be doing next time? Curbside pickup.
Plan B.
We're gonna make this, I just know this is gonna look great. So I'm really excited about it. And we get to use our Glowforge again because we're making it with 3D letters.
3D letters. Step one, we're gonna gather all of our supplies. This is a super simple shopping list, again. We just needed a couple of sheets of this hardboard. That's what we're gonna cut our letters out of. Two 1x2s, that's what we're gonna make our frame out of.
And some quarter inch plywood. You would need that at 16 by 72 or 6 feet. The home improvement store will cut that for you. However, we don't have any quarter inch plywood, but we do have this leftover eighth inch plywood, which we used for the shiplap. So we're going to glue them together and create quarter inch plywood.
Make it a little stiffer. And some paint.
Yep, and our paint.
Step two. Now we're gonna make all of our cuts. I'm gonna take this hardboard over to the Glowforge and cut out our letters. Ooh, I got a quick tip for you. I'll meet you there.
I imported a JPEG into Illustrator, did a quick image trace, black and white, deleted the background, expanded it, and gave each word its own color stroke. I then sized it and then stacked all the words on top of each other, saved it out as an SVG. Now in Glowforge, each of those different color strokes will come in as a different layer. You could set each one of those layers to cut, score, or engrave. You just ignore the layers that you don't want to deal with right now. And I'm gonna select cut for the layers that I do wanna cut right now. And repeat until you're done with all of your layers.
And now we're just gonna cut out this thin plywood. We're gonna cut it down to 72 inches. Then we're gonna glue it all together. I'm gonna do it with my little pocket saw. I told you I take this guy everywhere with me. We're gonna glue ours together and make the backboard. Where's the glue?
Right here.
All right, we're gonna let it dry. Let it dry. Step three! Now we're gonna paint. I'm gonna paint all these little letters and little words that we made. Happy. I'm gonna paint them with this black noir.
Chalk paint.
Oh, classic noir.
And I'm gonna paint the board. Well, I'm out of white, so I'm gonna paint this really, really, really light gray. It'll look white.
Yeah, it'll look white. Meet you outside. Now we're gonna assemble it. First, we're gonna glue down all of our words, looking all beautiful and black. Then we're gonna glue them down with some wood glue.
He is not into the E6000, if you watched last week's video.
I hate the E6000.
Or 2 weeks ago, I guess. He's not impressed.
It never dries, it always seems rubbery. Now we're gonna attach the frame. This is the 1x2 that we cut earlier. I'm gonna tack it together with a 1¼-inch brad. The nail, not the guy.
Ooh, that looks
bam, good. Bam, look at that. Look at that thing. Can you see it all at once?
That's beautiful.
It's hard to see it all at once. Hey, what do you guys think? Our scrap wood project turned out okay, right?
Turned out great. I love it.
If you like this week's video, remember to leave us a comment. Tell us what you like, didn't like. You got a problem with my hands? Let me know down below. If you're not yet subscribed, subscribe and tick that bell because we do this every week. And next week, we're making a farmhouse desk. So give us a like, a share, and maybe watch something over here, and we'll see you next week.